But first, Commissioner Bhargava is a civil rights lawyer with extensive experience in various roles advocating for members of underrepresented communities. In 2019, Commissioner Bhargava led a delegation of USCIRF to look into Vietnam's religious freedom conditions. After that country visit, she adopted Hoa Hảo Buddhist Nguyen Bac Truyen, who is serving an 11-year sentence as a religious prisoner of conscience. USCIRF reports have covered the counter religion year after year. Its 2019 report pointed out for the first time that the 1997 counter sect was not the same as the counter religion. This distinction is critical and is thus applauded by counter followers in Vietnam and overseas. Commissioner Bhargava, we hope to hear your assessment of how advocates for religious freedom in Vietnam can better support your work and vice versa, especially that now the State Department has decided not to list Vietnam as a country of particular concern or CPC this year.
Thank you so much. Yes, thank you so much, Dr. Tong. It's always such a pleasure to be able to be with you. And good morning to my fellow panelists and everyone who has joined us today. On behalf of the U.S. Commission on International Religious Freedom, or USCIRF, I want to thank you, Dr. Tong, and also Boat People SOS for organizing and inviting us to speak at SEAFoRB this year. For years, SEAFoRB has served as a meaningful forum for religious freedom advocates to come together and to share our work and information effort to promote religious freedom in Southeast Asia. I deeply appreciate the remarkable strength and sense of community, and I have been able to join you many times over the last few years. This incredible sense of community, not only at the conference, but that Boat People SOS has really been able to engender about Vietnam. USCIRF is committed to working with all of you and with civil society partners to advance religious freedom in Southeast Asia and in Vietnam. For those of you who are unfamiliar with USCIRF, and thank you, Dr. Tong, for speaking about our work so many times and being someone who's been an ambassador for it. USCIRF is an independent, bipartisan U.S. government body that was established by the 1998 International Religious Freedom Act. And our mandate is to monitor religious freedom worldwide. And we use international human rights standards, and we make policy recommendations to the US President, the Secretary of State, and to Congress. One of the most important things that we do each year is to publish an annual report where we describe religious freedom conditions in countries considered to be some of the worst violators of religious freedom around the world. And under IRFA, the State Department is required to designate as a country of particular concern, or CPC, any country with a government that engages in or tolerates systematic, ongoing, and egregious religious freedom abuses. In that regard, USCIRF has continually recommended that Vietnam be designated as a CPC for the last 20 years, including in our most recent 2021 annual report. As Dr. Tong mentioned, the State Department removed Vietnam from the country of particular concern list 15 years ago and did not designate Vietnam a CPC this past year. We continue to make the recommendation because we remain concerned that systematic, ongoing, and egregious violations of religious freedom still occur in Vietnam, despite modest and incremental improvements over the years. In 2019, USCIRF commissioners and staff traveled to Vietnam to meet with NGOs, faith communities, and government officials to discuss and raise concerns about religious freedom conditions in Vietnam. Our visit reinforced our CPC recommendation and some of the concerns that we have. In particular, the Vietnamese government has established, as many of you know, a systematic legal framework to actively restrict freedom of religion and its practice. Moreover, it continues to use non-state actors as well as state-backed religious organizations to suppress and intimidate independent religious groups. So we're here to talk about the Cao Dai religion. I want to speak about the Cao Dai for some time. The Cao Dai religion, as established in 1926, is a case in point. Government authorities have used a state-recognized Cao Dai group, also known as the 1997 sect. As Dr. Tong mentioned, we spoke about the 1997 sect, but it's been used to suppress independent Cao Dai followers. we had a chance to meet with independent Cao Dai members when we were in Vietnam, and we think the suppression by the state recognized groups continue. USCIRF reported in its 2021 annual report that authorities, in cooperation with the official Cao Dai group, harassed members of independent Cao Dai, attempting to take over their temples and force them to join the formal official government sanctioned group. USCIRF is concerned that such suppression of the independent Cao Dai community has continued to occur this past year, even as we have not been able to have the kind of presence and understanding of what's going on the ground as we may have in previous years. And I think it's important to note, one of the things I remember very clearly from my 2019 visit was the importance for those who are independent Cao Dai to be able to really have the freedom to practice their religion without the state getting involved. That is a tenet of what it meant to them to have religious freedom and central to the ways in which they wanted to practice. So amidst such a restrictive and challenging environment, independent Cao Dai followers have shown remarkable resilience and creativity in the effort to defend their religious freedom by practicing their religion at home. I truly commend the Cao Dai followers for their resilience and courage and for their fortitude in continuing to be able to find ways in which to come together. But even such peaceful home-based practice of religion has met with government interference and harassment. As systematic and egregious religious freedom abuses remain an ongoing reality for the Cao Dai and many other independent religious groups in Vietnam, USCIRF will continue to engage with and urge the Vietnamese government to respect religious freedom and related human rights. USCIRF will also continue to recommend to the U.S. government to make religious freedom an integral part of our foreign policy towards Vietnam amid deepening bilateral relations between the two countries. Thank you again for the invitation to join you today at this important convening.